Global connectivity is both a blessing and a curse, as highlighted by the massive disruption triggered by a faulty security update. Now, to help us make sense of what happened and how local systems can be protected, we're joined by Angel Redoble. He's the chairman of the Philippine Institute of Cybersecurity Professionals. Angel, good afternoon and welcome to Top Story.
Good afternoon, Stanley, and thank you for the invite.
All right. Maybe you can walk us through a bit, just a bit, on what happened, what companies were affected, because we've been hearing reports, of course, from the airlines, Cebu Pacific and a bit of Air Asia. But most of the reports are saying there are banks that are affected and even government offices. So as far as you know, in the Philippines, are there other companies aside from the airlines that were affected?
Well, yes, there are companies that have been affected but did not declare publicly.
Okay.
But we know that these companies are using the cybersecurity solution CrowdStrike. No, mm-hmm. There are also companies who are using but were not affected because they did not automatically deploy and install the
patch.
Updated
yeah.
agent.
Yeah.
Yeah, the patch.
Yeah.
So they were not affected. Assets that did not apply the patch were not affected. But banks, our airlines, I think in the U.S., the 911 was also affected. So this, yeah. This was a global... I don't agree not treating this as a cybersecurity incident because,
yeah.
you know, in cybersecurity, it's confidentiality, integrity, and availability.
Okay.
And obviously, the integrity of that patch was not vetted and vouched before it was released.
Okay.
And it caused availability issues across. No, these are critical services. And
yeah.
We are lucky that this is just something that you can reinstall or do something in a few days, although it will still be felt like your stocks. Options, for example, no, it affected a lot of listed, publicly listed, and
yeah.
publicly traded companies.
Yeah. Okay, Angel, just to give us a sense of just how big this is. Is CrowdStrike a leading company, a leading provider that many Philippine companies may have been using this facility or service?
Well, definitely, they've gained the traction in a few years ago, no, and not only in the Philippines. This is
worldwide.
Not only,
but would you consider CrowdStrike a big company or a major player in that sense?
Oh yeah, they are a major player at least in the endpoint and detection and response or EDR space of cybersecurity.
Okay, let me just clarify what you mentioned a while ago about the patch that has not been verified, that it may have resulted in something really serious and disruptive. Do you think the culpability of CrowdStrike is in question right now? I mean, must they answer for this?
Of course. I actually question how CrowdStrike practiced their governance in cybersecurity, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because We as organizations, we need to comply to having a governance practice in cybersecurity, mainly to prevent this kind of situations.
Yeah.
And if you are a major player or a global leader in cybersecurity, and you release a patch that has a bug, no, that caused mm-hmm. this blue screen of death. Well, there has to be penalties somewhere, no?
Mm-hmm.
Probably a financial penalty, or I don't know what else. What sector this CrowdStrike or regulator this CrowdStrike is complying to?
Mm-hmm.
But an explanation is not enough, no? Because
yeah.
we expect them to have this governance practice at the highest level because they are providing security to the whole country. And in this case, your cybersecurity solution is the one who caused this denial of service that we called, no? Because mm-hmm. it denied services to the organizations, it denied services to the community, it denied services to the global internet users.
Okay. Can we say for sure at this point that this is not a cybersecurity attack? You mentioned this was just a result of that patch that did not go well. But do you believe that at this point, or do you think there should be further investigation into the matter?
No, I do not believe that this is not a cyber attack at this point. And yes, there has to be a thorough investigation. We don't know yet. Is this just an unintentional mistake, or did something different happen that released someone was able to penetrate or intrude in any way and then release a patch that is really impossible to believe that CrowdStrike would release? No, someone released the bit by bit analysis of the file.
Okay.
And it's really not something that should be released by a major player like CrowdStrike.
Okay, Angel, is there supposed to be a backup, at least a backup system for companies using these products and services from CrowdStrike? Because I find it a bit incredulous, the fact that, you know, the only backup was a manual backup, at least for the airlines. They have, done things manually, and that seemed to be the only option. It's a bit unbelievable.
That is correct. Supposedly, when you release a patch, you need to make sure that if it didn't work, it will just fail over to the previous version.
Okay, so there should be some kind of reversion.
Yes, yes,
right.
It should not
right.
cause the blue screen of death. That is why in organizations side using CrowdStrike, yes, it is imperative to have a backup. But backup is also expensive, and cybersecurity is always dependent on the budget of the company and the revenue of the company. If you have good revenue, you probably will get good budget. If you have bad revenue, you get bad budget. Mm-hmm. Right? So the supposedly the one that should have done its job to make sure that patches released are good and vetted must be the company who is releasing the patch.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That it is a no-no for any big company or player globally to release such patch that can cause this global outage.
All right. Lastly, Angel, you know, a lot of companies affected are saying it may take days before business returns to normal. Is there a way to at least speed up the process to get them back on their feet? Or do you think CrowdStrike should be obligated to speed things up, assist in other ways to, bring business back to normal?
Well, I hate to say it, but there is no shortcut, no? Especially if your organization is relatively big and you have hundreds or thousands of assets.
Okay.
And it is also an imperative measure for each and every organization to make sure that when they boot up everything, when they put everything back to operational status, that this thing will not reoccur.
All right. On that note, Mr. Angel Redoble, thank you so much for joining us on Top Story today for this conversation and for the explanation. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you for having me, Stanley, and Top Story. Thank you.
All right. Happy weekend.